Konnichiwa Bhagwan, everyone. A short tutorial on interval bisection. So here's a simple question. Perform three interval bisections to find the root of f of x equals x squared minus 8. Now, first of all, what does finding a root means? It means when the function itself equals 0. And you can see I've chosen a very simple function here that we could actually sort of work out roughly in our heads just so we know where we're going. But often it's very complicated functions that we wouldn't be able to solve. I mean, of course, we could solve this one. We could say x squared must equal 8. So I can see that x equals the square root of 8. So that's a good approximation to begin with. But of course, I don't know what the square root of 8 is. Now, if I just give you an interval that this could lie on first, if x was 2, then x squared would be 4. And if x was 3, 3 squared would be 9. So clearly the root of this, if I just call it alpha, it must lie on the line, well, somewhere between 2 and 3. Okay? Now, of course, you could do the square root of 8 on your calculator. Remember, this is often used for much more complicated functions. So how do we do this interval bisection? Well, effectively, we know it lies between 2 and 3. We're simply going to keep cutting that in half over and over again, well, 3 times, until we get a more accurate approximation. And I'm going to show you a good way of laying that out on your page. Before I do that, let's just prove that it's between 2 and 3. And it's often a question, show that the root lies between 2 and 3. And what we do, we substitute the 2 into my function. Now obviously that's 2 squared minus 8, which is 4 minus 8, that's minus 4. Notice that is less than 0. If I substitute 3 into my function, I have 3 squared minus 8, well that's 9 minus 8, that's plus 1. And that is bigger than 0. And it's this change of sign, the fact that 1 is less than 0 and 1 is bigger than 0, that tells me that the solution that gives me 0 must be on that interval. So I'm going to go smack down the middle and I'm going to choose 2.5 for my first interval bisection. So the first thing I'm going to do is substitute 2.5 into my function. Now, you will need a calculator for this stage, so you're going to do 2.5 squared minus 8. And if you're very quick on your calculator, probably quicker than me, I get the answer minus 1.75. Now, what's important is that is less than 0. So I now need to decide, am I between 2.5 and 2, or between 2.5 and 3? Now, you can see 2 was less than 0. 2.5 is still less than 0, so it's not big enough. So now I'm going to be between 3 and 2.5. So I'm going to go between these two here. So what is between 2.5 and 3? Well, if you're not sure, I mean, obviously you can do it on a calculator easy enough. A good way to do it is you add the two numbers together. So 2.5 plus 3 and divide by 2. And you do it on a calculator or you do it in your head, whatever's fastest for you, and you get 2.75. I know that's obvious, but I'm showing you obvious numbers so you can follow this through. So I now consider the function of 2.75. That's my second interval bisection. My first was the 2.5. I've now cut a smaller interval. So I'm going to put this into the function. Just keep repeating your function, minus 8, as quickly as you can on your calculators. And I get minus, in this case I get minus 0.4375. Notice that is still smaller than 0, it's still negative. For some reason my pen has completely stopped working, so it's smaller than 0. So I always want to go between the one that's smaller than 0 and bigger than 0. The one that's bigger than 0 is still f of 3 up there, and the one that's smaller than 0 is this one here. So I'm still between now 2.75 and 3. Add them together on your calculator and divide by 2 and you'll get 2.875. So that's going to be the third interval bisection that I'm going to try. So I'm going to do the function of 2.875. Substitute that into my function. And as quickly as you can on your calculator, And this time I've got 0.265625. Now notice this time that one is bigger than 0. Okay? So that is too big. I don't need to go all the way up to 3 this time. I'm going to trap it between the last one I did that was lower than 0 and the one I've just done, which is bigger than 0. And so what does this help me do? Well, it doesn't give you an answer. That's not what interval by bisection does, but it gives you intervals. It gets smaller and smaller intervals. So therefore, alpha, which is the root, now lies on the interval 2.75 to 2.875. I've got a much smaller interval. Remember I said at the start, it's between 2 and 3. I now know very, very closely it's between 2.75 and 2.875. So just remember, you keep taking the middle, but then you choose the two values that are, one's bigger than 0 and one is less than 0 at all times. If you found this video useful, please do share it using the link, put it on your Facebook wall, tweet about it. Your friends are really going to thank you if you do anything that helps them do well. And I want to help you do well, so follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook, you'll keep updated with all the tutorials I do, and get in touch and request anything you need to do as well as you can. Good luck in your exams, guys. I really hope you're going to do well.